not even right.
Right up front. Right up front.
Watch it, Alex, can you record?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Somebody should record my things down.
I got it.
You're recording?
Christian told me, Joey, and you.
Yeah.
Who wants to do it?
Okay.
Let's get every angle possible.
That little drone like right here.
So first thing, rough up the bottom of your socket so that our grip will stick, okay? Don't forget to do that. And then get this all set up and then be like, oh shoot, I didn't rough it up. I have to take it all out and redo it. So do that first. Next thing, so you have a pylon with a tube clamp on either end or some version of this. You have your four hole connector, a pyramid, some screws. This is for the gunk that you guys are gonna use. So instead of mixing the gunk in the cup like you did last time, you're gonna use this, which is called FabTech. It's just an adhesive. It sets off really quick. It's not smelly, so it's much more convenient for us to use. Especially when you guys are all gonna be in here throughout, you know, probably a short time frame trying to bench align. This room gets really smelly. There's no ventilation in here, so it's not a good place to be using the resin. So anyways, next thing is, does anybody remember how to do this? Yeah, Cisco?
Me and Joe struggled at the end of the lab last time, but
okay,
more or less.
So to begin with, the first thing, just want to take a look at your pylon here and make sure that your tube clamps are lined up so that they're, one is not slightly rotated in relation to the other. If you have a one of the pylons that has this female adapter integrated into it and it doesn't have this set screw, that's fine. Just line up the center of this screw with the center of that screw. And so mine is rotated a little bit, so just gonna fix that. So when I do this, to start with, I want everything in neutral. Okay, so next is just gonna be to put this on here. It doesn't really matter which way it goes, with either these facing out or facing back, or I usually do it, I don't do it to the side. That's probably just an OCD thing. It really doesn't matter that much, but I usually either put this in the front or the back. The trick also to getting to this back screw, so because it's hard to get your wrench in there to tighten that one, so I'm going to loosen the front a lot and then tighten the back one a little bit. So can you get a view of that? Are you videoing? Can you see that?
Mm-hmm.
Like the inside? Yeah? Okay. So that way when I put this on, I don't have to tighten that back screw. I can just tighten the other three and it should wind up pretty close to the neutral position that I'm looking for. So this pylon should be vertical in coronal and sagittal plane. Okay, so I can check that with my plumb bob. So what I'm looking for is my plumb line to drop through the center of this top screw and then also through the center of the bottom screw. I'm going to check that in the sagittal plane and also the coronal plane. And these momos are a little bit tight, so I'm just going to get in here and see. So right now, mine is off a little bit. So I need to bring the top of my pylon back, which means I need to tighten that back screw just a little bit. So I'm going to see if I can get in there. I'm going to loosen the front one. So this wrench has a ball end on it, so that you can kind of get in there with the, if you have a ball end, because you can turn the screw at an angle. Okay, so I got a couple of degrees of motion there. Let's see if that is enough. Play in it so you can see that. So I want to tighten this. Now this won't move anymore. Alright, that one looks good. Okay, so next step, just put this on there. Use these little screws. You don't actually have to do all four of them. If you don't want, you can just do two, because this is just a temporary setup. You're going to disassemble this later and put regular screws in there. So and you don't have to make these super tight either, because you're just going to take it apart later. Now you want the top of this to be level in, again, both sagittal and coronal planes. So if you have a level, you can just set it right on top and check it in both directions. Or you can, that's probably the most accurate way. You can also, you can just kind of eyeball it and make sure that each, all four of these screws are pushed in the same amount. Okay. So we have that, that's all set up. Next thing is just getting our socket set up in the Momo and the Halo in there. Okay, so we have three things that we're looking for here. Socket rotation, socket flexion, and socket adduction. Our lines are gonna give us our flexion and our adduction. We're gonna use our posterior wall to make sure it's in the correct rotation. So like I said, I want everything in neutral. So the issue, let's say that I got this rotated, I'll make it look extreme. I put it in there like that, and I connected my four-hole plate to it with that amount of rotation. Well, now when the patient puts it on, all of this is gonna rotate externally, right? And so now when I make angular changes to my socket using the screws, those angular changes are not going to be happening in the coronal or sagittal plane anymore. They're going to be happening at some diagonal plane. And so if I'm trying to make an adjustment for a gait deviation, like I need to outset the foot and I need to make an angular change, I'm not going to be able to work in those planes that I'm looking for. So I'm not really going to be able to outset the foot. I'm not going to be able to truly plantar flex or dorsiflex, because it's going to be happening in a different plane of motion. So the rotation is really important. We will do some external rotation of the foot. So we talked about toe in and toe out already. That's just going to happen down here. So it's not going to change any of this. So all you're going to do is loosen the set screw and rotate the foot externally. So if you're still making socket angular changes up here, they're still happening in the correct planes. If that makes sense. Okay. So I use the posterior wall, and I basically just line it up with this flat, the back part of this claw. So first thing I'm going to do is get that set up in the right amount of rotation, and then I'm going to look at this lateral alignment line for my socket flexion, okay? So I want that align, that line on the lateral side to be vertical. So those are the two things I'm looking for right now. Make sure this is, and then I'm only gonna tighten these two front screws here. Also, just be aware when you're putting this in, try to put your socket like in the center of this thing. So if you get it like pushed too far to one side or the other, you may run out of alignment down here. So again, everything just start out in neutral, in the center, in neutral position. So, and also don't necessarily butt your socket up against the back here, because I may need to rotate this to get the correct amount of flexion. So give yourself just a little bit of space back there. Can you tighten that one for me, Alex? Okay, so now it's held in place, but I can still pivot, right? So now I can, my rotation is held, so I don't have to worry about that anymore. And now I can work on this line and get it where it is vertical. Actually, I need to go back and check on this line first before I start messing with that one. So, can you see? Can mm-hmm. you want to come over here? So I'm going to make a little adjustment here because we can see that my anterior alignment line is not quite vertical. So I need a little bit more abduction of this socket to get it vertical. So I'm just going to loosen this one side, abduct a little, tighten that back down. Okay, that looks good. Now I can come over here to get this lateral alignment line vertical. And then I'm going to tighten down the back two bolts, and that's going to hold that in the flexion that I want. Rotation, flexion, adduction. This is in neutral. The last two things we need to get are our foot position for our AP and our ML, right? So for AP, so we're gonna use these lines again because these are representing our weight lines, right? We just talked about heel levers, toe levers, all of that stuff, which is in relation to the patient's weight line, right? So if this is representing the patient's weight line, then I wanna position my foot underneath that line correctly. So for AP, let's do AP first. I want if I run my plumb bob, my plumb line right along this line that I made on the lateral side, that is basically an extension of their weight line. So I'm gonna run this, so where should this be in relation to the foot?
1 inch anterior.
That's right. So 1 inch anterior to the foot bolt, which the foot bolt is the center of this lateral screw, okay? So I'm gonna shift this bottom piece. I can move the socket forward and back, and I can move the foot forward and back. Okay, so whatever I need to do in order to get my plumb line to the point that it's 1 inch anterior to this bolt. So right now, my weight line is just posterior to that bolt. So I either need to move my socket forward or I need to move my foot backward. I'm going to move the